just be ching-ching. It would be, my advertisers would really enjoy it. Lots of money would flow because the amount of people that would see it all over the world, both the video ads and the graphic ads, they'd be very happy, and so would I.
Okay. So on Tuesday with Laura Diaz's show and with the Lucky Harman show, you can tell the times, we're going to translate them in all languages.
Is that what we're doing, Melissa?
That's what we're doing.
That sounds super. So live Tuesday, July 7th. At 2 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, we're having an Actors Eat Chat show with Laura Diaz. She's an anchor for Fox 11. She's an independent journalist and a producer, and I'm a big fan of hers. Kurt's going to host that. And then at 4 o'clock, and both of these are at the iActor Studios here in Burbank, California. They are terrific studios with amazing people that help make it very easy to be here. Applause, thank you so much. At 4 o'clock, we're going to shoot a side beat music show, also here at the iActing Studios, and Lucky Harman is going to be the guest. He's a hip-hop artist that's a very popular artist. And we're going to translate both of them simultaneously, real time.
Mm-hmm.
And
he has an incredible social media following, so I'm sure we're going to see our numbers blow up.
So this is going to be fun. This is going to be our first real
multilingual
to see.
First time it's ever been done anywhere.
There you go.
And we're doing it with Pepper Jenny.
And thank you so much for including me.
Getting all tingly and emotional at this moment. speaking of tingly and emotional, let's talk about the things that a lot of people like to know about, which is financial. And we brought Salazar, who is a wizard at entertainment, at law, at finance. And does religion fall into your food group or not?
Sure.
Maybe you could give a little explanation about who you are and what your expertise are.
Okay. Greetings, world. I'm Salazar. I come to you by way of iActor Studio in beautiful Burbank, California, and I hail from southwest Atlanta, Georgia. Basically, we're coming here today to just speak to you a little bit about the technology that we have before you. And as you've seen the media component and the entertainment component, there are also two facets that I don't want to be overlooked, which is the actual commerce component, be it international and government. Communication is the science of life. Imagine if you can go anywhere in the world and immediately you can communicate efficiently and effectively with everyone that you interact with. That's going to make you one uninhibited and unhindered individual. And it's going to allow you to have a much more global presence whether you're an individual, corporation, or a business with a sole proprietorship. So the actual aspects of business, this is at the forefront of the market to revolutionize the way international business is done. This will allow companies in countries to come together and to facilitate trade agreements, contractual relationships, and not have any kind of communication hindrances which will not impede their businesses. On the government level, this will allow governments to come together and to have peace treaties and to have actual negotiations to facilitate better relationships within their governments, which will increase, from my perspective, it will increase global humanity. And that's one of the important things that we look at. So it's also the media side, which of course is, we're in the entertainment capital of the world, so we live, eat, sleep, and breathe entertainment by way of nature of where we happen to be. But there's also the business component that comes with the international business that also comes with the government markets. Also, this can help global security. The way the government works, anytime there's something that helps another government, say the Department of Defense or our federal government puts out a master agreement which would allow other subsidiaries of the government to facilitate an interaction with this software. This would assist FBI, CIA, Homeland Security, and our international partners in security such as Interpol, United Nations, and Arab League of Nations. So the actual benefits that this software has is exponential on all levels. And it would have revenue streams in the first 5 million, which we prospect would be anywhere from 75 billion to 500 billion. And that's billion with a B. So the actual components are going to be different based upon what the usage is for. So if the usage is going to be for a contract, of course, the licensing agreement is going to be totally different, whereas if it's going to be for a feature-length film. Because if it's a feature-length film, of course, we're going to be doing a translation that's going to be 90 minutes or thereafter. If it's just a contract, it's going to be, of course, however many pages the contract is. So that's going to be a much more limited agreement. So the actual breakdown of the software, also, we want to implore that it has a digital footprint. So there will be security in place to protect the agreements and protect whatever content, whether it's intellectual property or whether it's your contractual relations or whether it's your trade secrets or your copyright and trademark and patent protected product. So there are actual software and protocol sort of safeguards, if you would, which will protect the content. But it just, each revenue stream is going to be different based upon what the usage is for. So I just wanted to let you know that it's got many different components to it, which will allow us to make a global impact, which allow us to revolutionize not only media, but also business and also government. So, thank you.
Thank you very much. And I'd like to call up Jim Alay, who works at NTV, and she's going to share some entertainment statistics with us.
Okay, for those who don't know me, my name is Jamie Ray. I work for NBC Turkey, and I have been in the same company like for 13 years. It's been a long time. Okay, as you can see here, there are over 6,100 production houses in the U.S. This is only in the U.S. If you just count the world, it's going to be more. It's not as much as the one that we have in Turkey because we're not as a big country as that you are, but okay. And of those, over 1.25 million is spent among major production houses per quarter on translations. Okay, this is a really strong number. We do spend lots of money on translation, not as much as this one, but we spend too much money on translation as well. There is around $31 billion generated in this space alone, only in this space. And internationally, there are over 40,000 in 149 countries. And
that's 40,000 production houses.
Production houses, okay, thanks for the sample. Content is produced and marketed in typically 1 to 2 languages. This is only 1 to 2 languages, so there should be more. And content in 33 languages is a paradigm shift and a game changer. Okay, I would like to say something to you. We do translation in many, many languages, like in Japan, in Japanese, in Chinese, in Italian. We work with translators. But we depend on human beings, like people, real people, which mean that there is a time consumption and too much money involved. If we could just have a system in NBC Turkey and have it work there properly, this means that NBC Turkey is going to just make way much money over this. And it is really going to save us time. So, because there are usually some delays in productions and delays in translations, which probably you should know that because delays in production.
Wow, that happens.
Yes, delays in
production. Oh my gosh!
Which is a chain reaction.
Yeah,
which is
and so then if you're air date is still coming, it doesn't change that fact that you still haven't translated it.
I would like to give you a very specific example. For example, Game of Thrones in Turkey, as far as I remember, airs on Sundays, 24 hours later than in England, Great Britain. And they don't let us use the high quality video, naturally. They don't.
So
just for translation.
They get low res.
Yeah, we get low res. And what we normally have is like a few hours of time to translate all the show. This is a 45-minute show, and the language is pretty heavy. It's a tough language. Mm-hmm. It's very old, has very different, words in it. So you need to look it up from the dictionary, internet. It's so interesting, so interesting. So what we usually have here is like a few hours left to the show, and we go like, oh my God, are we going to make it to the show? Yes, we should be going to make it to the show. So we usually, spend like hours on translation, then subtitling. Not only translation. When translation is over, we go to the subtitling room and we wait for the subtitling, which is in real time, like it takes up 45 minutes to 47 minutes or 48 minutes in tops, which is a whole lot of process and a whole lot of time, as you can see.
So the factoring difference is we've saved all the time.
Yeah, absolutely.
We've saved all the
money,
resource of person power.
Yeah.
And we're doing it at a fraction of the cost.
Absolutely.
At a fraction of the time.
Mm-hmm.
Someone has joined us who has said that if we can show that this is 95% accurate,
mm-hmm.
That they would launch it immediately at seven television networks near
mm-hmm.
you.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously we're going to have to test each one of the 33 languages
mm-hmm.
to demo that each work at 95%, but if so, then we can announce that we'll be doing translations for seven networks immediately in addition to other stuff. Is there other aspects you wanted to cover?
No, that's all.
Did you cover all your notes?
I did.
Okay, you're dismissed.
Thank you.
Salazar.
Sir.
He's back.